Hello, dearlings. Welcome to the next video in my series about color theory. Today we're going to talk about primary colors and make a color wheel with watercolors. This time I'm using a different set than my pans from the last video. I have a Winsor Newton Cotman set of tube colors and I've purchased one additional color to be able to do this tutorial. Today I'm painting a Yerby wheel, which I first discovered in a great book called Color and Light by James Gurney. The idea behind this wheel is that blue, red, and yellow are not primary colors. This wheel asks us to consider that there are six primary colors: yellow, red, magenta, blue, cyan, and green. If you've ever had trouble mixing vibrant colors, there's a good chance it's because you've been missing cyan and magenta, which are nearly impossible to mix. So as I'm painting this, my goal is to try and mix all these colors using only yellow, magenta, and cyan. The tubes that correspond are cerulean blue hue, permanent rose, and cadmium yellow pale hue. Because I know that while it will be tedious, I can mix red and blue using these colors, I'm going to. My goal isn't to make this easy so much as to gain skill in color mixing and learn more. So why do we consider red, yellow, and blue to be primary colors? A lot of it has to do with the history of paint. The ability to synthesize affordable versions of both magenta and cyan is a relatively new invention and concept. Because for so long yellow, red, and blue were used as primaries, it's very difficult to learn this as a society. And you are still taught, for simplicity's sake, that the primaries are yellow, red, and blue in grade school, even if this isn't the case. It wasn't until recently that we as a society were able to break down the science of light and discover cyan and magenta played a much bigger role in color theory than we had previously thought. Speaking of light, it's worth mentioning that everything you learn when mixing colors for traditional media can be useless if you're working digitally. There are some digital art programs that mimic traditional processes very closely, but the ones that don't, you'll be mixing light instead of paint. What does this mean? If you mix red, green, and blue paint, you'll get mud. But if you mix red, green, and blue light, like when painting digitally, you'll actually get white. When mixing light, red, green, and blue are primaries, and cyan, magenta, and yellow are secondary colors. Alright, so why are we painting a wheel? So I'm focused on color and hue intensity with this project. Did you know that if you add a color's direct opposite in small increments, you'll reduce a color's intensity until it becomes either brown or gray? This wheel is a huge exercise in control. The idea is to get close to brown or gray in the center, but not mix the color on the opposite end of the wheel. If you treat colors this way, you'll actually never need a black or a white paint. Even though using cyan and magenta paints opens up a whole new spectrum of colors to paint, it's still not enough. The spectrum of visible light is incredibly larger than what we can mix, and when we're painting digitally, we need to accept that some colors cannot be printed using traditional methods. For example, you can't mix or print a neon color, even if you can paint with it digitally. If this is the case, then how does neon clothing exist, you might ask? How did they print neon on books and magazines that you see in stores? The answer is Pantones or spot colors. Pantone colors are produced chemically by the Pantone company that came into being in the 1950s. They guarantee exact color matching. If you're requesting multiple Pantone or spot colors in a print job, it can get expensive, but there will be no color variance. If you want to paint in neons, you'll need to buy a neon paint. If you want to print in neons, you'll have to order a separate spot color. And if you want to make something look neon but not use neon paint, that's related to how colors can influence each other. And that's a different video. So there's some interesting revelations when you look at the wheel, such as opposite colors. We can see on the Yerby color wheel, red and green are not actually opposites. They are in fact not even close. So to reduce red's intensity, we actually want to add cyan. To reduce magenta, we want to add green. And to reduce purple, we want to add yellow-green. So my biggest problems came from being really heavy-handed with this color wheel, and there are a few times I had to lift color and try again. Some of them turned brown pretty quickly, such as the green-yellow. So I had a little bit of problems with that. I would like to do this wheel over again to see if I could get a better result, and I feel like it's a great project to just do every now and then to keep your skills sharp when it comes to color mixing. So that's about it. If you have any questions about color mixing or color wheels that you think I could answer, either in comments or a future video, just let me know. I'd be happy to help.